Welcome to the Matrix with your boy, Prime Style. You know what time it is, so let's get it. What's up, everybody? Before we get on started, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, make sure you hit the Taco Bell sign to get the notification sent to your email or your notification signs on your phone. So that way you'll know when I upload my material and you will not miss a beat on everything that I deliver to everyone for the community. And I would truly appreciate it. Thanks for dropping in for this segment of The Matrix with your boy Prime. I'm glad y'all can officially join me on this lovely, lovely day. Today is December 7th of 2017. And remember what I always specify for years and what I've always preached. Regression is not necessary. We want to get NBA Live back to where it needs to be. Regression is not something that is acceptable, but progression is acceptable. Well, I can tell you this, NBA Live community. They have been listening to us as a community. Like I tell my lady, just because it's not when you want it at that time, it may be delayed, but it's going to happen. And I feel that now that EA and the NBA Live team, they are working. And with the little team that they do have, because they have a small team. The NBA Live team is not that big, but they have the progression. As you're looking at it right now, everything that we have been presented with so far, and what they've been doing and what they have been incorporating into the NBA Live franchise. And there have been things that, you know, a lot of us get angry with. Like a couple of my videos that I rant in, it's because of my passion. My passion for the title is there. This is not something that is falsified. It's not about EA. It's about NBA Live. And it's about the title. And it's about the title coming back to where it needs to be. And this is the progression that we have been getting. We've been getting everything that you see. Exclusiveness with the actual apparel. You're getting everything that EA is known for over all this time and over the years. And they have been getting back to what it is that they are known for. And getting things that is authentic and bringing everything back to NBA Live. Well, I got some great news for everyone. NBA Live community, it is finally here for all of y'all. Here you go. Now, since we have roster editing and it is back in NBA Live, I need all you people out there that contradict yourselves, because I know a lot of you do it anyway. Roster editing is in the game. Now go buy it. Go pick it up. Because a lot of you talk a lot of mad shit. And don't say that I talk a lot of mad stuff, because my rants and what I say about the NBA Live title, that's because I love NBA Live and I want it better. I want it to get back to where it used to be. Not all this form of regression. So, as you're seeing right here, ladies and gentlemen, you have the default roster, where you can save your active roster, and then you can load it. So you can do all that. So let's just say if I wanted to edit a particular roster, I could just go up in here and it's going to import the rosters right now. It's going to load everything up. So, as you see, now we have the active roster file, we have free agents, we have player rotations, and then we have create player. You can make up to 135 created players. You see that? 135 players created. You can make up to 135 created players. For all you editing junkies that want everything, you have that option. So you should be happy. And I know a lot of you are going to complain about all the little stuff. Just be happy that the dedication to the effort of putting in the roster editing when the NBA Live community been saying it for years. And all I say is that form of regression is not necessary. This is form of regression is not necessary. We want progression. We want every element, everything that needs to be incorporated, that should be in the title, that needs to be there, needs to be there. Simple as that. Now, we're going to go ahead and go into the free agency. That's actually what I'm going to mess with. So you select the player. So you go ahead and you select the player that you want. So it looks like, so, and you can edit whatever it is that you want. You just go on in there. You select what you want. Now, you have an overview. You can do the skills. You can edit the player. You can assign the player to a team if you choose to. See what I'm saying, ladies and gentlemen? So all of you that's out there that wanted roster editing, not just myself, because I feel that it should have been in the game as a whole. And, you know, now they finally implemented it in the franchise. And they put it back to where it needs to be. So, all I can say is that you go in here, and let me just, you know, tweak with it just a tad, you know. Again, like I say, roster editing is not a big deal to me, but for all you creators that are out there, this is good for you because options are extremely good. You have to have the option to do that, and it's just a simple, it's just something that is simple for you to do for yourself. Now, this is the main thing that I care about right here, is that now you do your player rotations. Finally, player rotations. Now, they took a page out of 2K, which I really, really don't like. That's just me. That's just my personal opinion, where you can set the actual minutes of the players. Don't get me wrong, it's a form of simulation, it's a form of the way that you do it, but at the same time, me personally, I am a little bit old school. The roster should be accurate, but then at the same time, with the rosters being accurate, I feel that me as a player, I just want the rosters to be in the right sequence. So let's just say this is their true starting lineup right here, but I don't need to have the actual computer dictate who I want to sub in and who I want to sub out. I don't want that. And where they have minutes restrictions. See me, I don't like that. I think that's a form of, to me, just with this today's player. I'm not saying that the addition is lazy. I'm not saying that. I'm saying that a lot of players that are out there with this being implemented, but because this is a 2K implementation, where you adjust the minutes, you got the minutes remaining on the minutes that are, you know, for each player, and then you have to adjust it. So if you have it on auto, the computer is automatically going to sub your guys. This is for people that want that option, if they want the computer to sub their guys in. To me personally, this is just my personal opinion. Now also, you are not going to be able to upload your players, so upload your rosters. If you do like personal rosters, you're not going to be able to upload them where you can share them to people. Now that's going to be in further titles, but the significance is that we do have the roster editing back. It is back into full effect, and that's the first thing. So we have to, you know, those steps are going to be coming, but roster editing is finally back in the title. And again, we haven't had roster editing ever since Live 10. that's almost 9 years ago, people. I mean, that's almost 8 years ago. So don't complain about the little stuff, ladies and gentlemen. Just be happy that roster editing has been incorporated into the title, you know, moving forward. So a lot of you that really, really like franchise and you really want to do your players and edit them, you can now. You can do all the significant things that you want to do with your franchise mode and moving forward. And I feel that they're not done still implementing things to incorporate new things into, or particular elements to put into the franchise and bringing it back. And I'm very, very, very happy about it. So back to the roster editing. You can adjust this you know, to the minutes what they actually play in real life, which is a good thing. And you can adjust the rotations to whatever it is that you want now. You can change it up. You can cut the players. You can edit them. You can trade them. Now you can assign the player what it is that it needs to be done. Now you can see their skills. They move this over. So this is very good. This is very, very good. Okay? Very good. Now you can go over. You can see their contract on how long it is. You can adjust it. The option type. The front load. You just miss it. You check their contract. Look at that. It goes up to 6 years. It tell you how much they make. That is what I'm talking about. Okay? This implementation is beautiful. I like that because I want to see all that. That is sim. That's what needs to be in the game. Now, let's go ahead and go here. So the only thing that I would say, ladies and gentlemen, is this. Is that they got it in the game. They put it in the game. And, you know, all I want them to do now, okay? The only thing that I need them to do now is one thing and one. Y'all probably know where I'm about to go with this. Y'all know where I'm about to go, all right? DNA, baby. Where is the synergy? Where is the synergy? I'm not trying to knock anything down the parade because this is a very, very great moment for us in the NBA Live community. This is a lovely moment. Where is the synergy? Where is the breakdown of the synergy? The synergy is not in here. Okay? It is not in here at all. You know? So we need to have that. You know, you have the exclusive rights to synergy. And where is it at? Where are the tendencies? Where are they at? That's what we need, okay? We need to have that. You know, we need to have that. As you see here, you can offer them a contract if you want to. So there are a lot of things that you can do now with the roster editing that a lot of you players out there that really want it. And just the breakdown and what it does, that is what I wanted. I want the breakdowns. That's what I like. I love the breakdowns. So that is significant enough. I want those breakdowns. Let me go ahead and go here. Let's see. Now the active roster, they say that you can edit. See, now you can change this. So that is the main thing that you can do. That's the thing that I cared about. You know, so now we can go into, and they changed the whole format of the roster too. So that's a good thing. And this is something that's significant enough for me. I'm going to go to my Los Angeles Lakers. And there we go. So my thing is, ladies and gentlemen, is that, you know, they changed the format of it and they put everything in, you know. Now they still have not put Tim Hardaway and some guys' faces in the game. So they need to get on the ball with that when it comes down to those pitchers. They have to put these pitchers in the game. It's just the little things that's still there. I'm not trying to go into it, but other than that, this is a very, very big win-win for the NBA Live community going forward. So all I can say, ladies and gentlemen, is that enjoy the title. If you was talking a lot of smack and you said, well, roster editing is your breaking point on the reason why you're not getting NBA Live, well, get your butt off the couch. Get on your console and purchase the game. The game is only $29.99. That's it. If roster editing was a breaking point for you, well, now it's in the game. Ain't no excuse for you not to go ahead and go get the title. This is your boy Prime. I appreciate y'all for dropping in for this segment of The Matrix with your boy. Glad to go ahead and get the title. And again, roster editing has been incorporated back into the NBA Live franchise. It's about time. I'm out of here.
And P.S. before I close, as you're looking up here up on the screen, Erica just sent this tweet out as I was making this video. And as you see, they fixed a lot of players. They fixed Isaiah Thomas, and they're going to be implementing more stuff in a couple more days. All right, y'all. I'm Ghost. Peace.